Driving a motorhome in wind like this, it's kind of like landing a plane in turbulence. Because I've landed so many planes in turbulence, right? It is sketch to the max, though.
Ever since I was a kid, all I wanted to be was an explorer. Sail the seven seas, find new worlds.
But Uncle D, everything's already been found.
What? Like everything?
Well, yeah.
Oh, man.
Well, so much for that. But if I can't be an explorer, I can still be an adventurer. So I bought a motorhome, and I'm hitting the open road. My name is Dustin Porter, and this is Destination Adventure.
Problem here. Just spent the last month pampering you. What more do you want from me? A trip to Mexico. After all this. Let's whip it.
I've never seen it rain here this consistently for this long, but I also don't spend a whole lot of time in the lower mainland, but there's rivers coming down everywhere on the mountain. So we're gonna hike up and see Bridal Veil Falls. I bet it's gonna be pretty treacherous right now.
Usually this whole area just full of people. One big rainstorm and everyone's gone. But look at it. It's amazing.
If you're ever in Vancouver and it's raining, take the opportunity to come out and see this with all the tourists. Let's get out of here.
Wet one.
With so many highways washed out, thousands of people are stranded.
Many British Columbians have evacuated their homes due to torrential rains and landslides that have forced the closure of several major highways.
All the highways connecting the lower mainland and the rest of the country are shut down. On this Monday night, torrential rain and fierce winds.
We begin in southern BC, where relentless rain has caused chaos on the roads.
Water rushes underneath a now completely severed section of the Coquihalla Highway.
Slept almost none last night. The rain here has just been crazy, just hammering the motorhome to the point where I have a substantial amount of water coming in, which has never been an issue for me. But I have these towels hung up. The leak is somewhere right up in here. So I have these towels hanging here. And the idea is they work kind of like a wick, and the water will kind of soak up and then run down the towel instead of running down the walls, which was it was at first. So I'm up every 2 hours changing those. Just looked at the news. Things are looking pretty nasty out there, so I really have to push to get across the border today. I have my wheel alignment booked at 11, so I'm gonna load up and head over there. Holy smokes. That's just my luck. Cal Tire, actually nowhere apparently in the lower mainland here, can do a wheel alignment on this style motorhome. And I'm right at my border crossing now, and the flooding is so bad here that the border crossing's closed. So hit the Google machine, see if we can find another border crossing, I guess. Just got off the phone with CBP at Sumas, and they are open, but every road following is closed, so there's no way south after the crossing. So I'm gonna head over to Aldergrove, give it a try. I'm almost certain I'll be pulled into secondary just because I'm a younger person snowbirding, but I'm hoping they'll kind of be a little bit more forgiving just because of the weather and everything right now, and it's been a freaking stressful couple days already. Wow, there's nobody here. Hello. How's it going?
All right.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Holy frick, look at those trucks. Oh man, there's a canoe over here. What's going on with that canoe?
Originally the plan was to go down to Highway 101, do the coast along Washington, Oregon, up to my grandpa's place. This storm is just relentless. The rain and the wind, and a bunch of the Highway 101 is actually washed out. So, apologize guys, I'm just pushing straight through to my grandpa's. Can't risk it. I have not felt like this since I got evacuated during the wildfires, and we were just running from one evacuation point to the next, getting chased by the fires. Now this flooding, I'm just trying to get through this, but every time I get somewhere, the roads are shutting down, like right in front of me in Bellingham right now. I think once, if I can get through Bellingham onto the freeway, I think it'll be okay. But now I've been in Bellingham for about, I don't know, 40 minutes. As soon as I get to a place, the police are there just shutting down the road and water's just flowing over top. It's crazy. Finally found my route out of Bellingham, just pulling onto the I-5 now. And I'll be on the I-5 pretty much all the way through to Oregon, so should be good to go. I can't believe it, you guys. Almost in Seattle. Look at it. There's blue sky up there. It's amazing. Not really excited to be taking the I-5 all the way because I have to go right through Seattle and Portland. Pretty big cities for the motorhome, but it seems to be the only highway that's gonna get me all the way there right now. So, high five for the I-5, let's whip it. Going right through Seattle now. I don't know what happened. It's like I came through a door
where it was just pouring rain and wind, and then nothing. I had to put on my sunglasses. It's blue sky here, hardly a cloud in the sky. Things are looking good. You guys, living full-time in a motorhome and traveling, it's an amazing experience. When you go through emergency situations like I did back in the Lower Mainland, it can get very stressful. So I want to end this video on a positive note, and it is positive. Get to see my grandparents today. Haven't seen them in 3 years because of COVID. Today's a good day.
Bring me to the Valley of Peace. Spare my heart and I'll reach to the end of the road. Release me from the chains of my mind. Pain I cannot define pierces me all the way down. 'Cause all I ever want is you. Even sometimes I realize that nothing feels right. Only you, you give me heaven. Only you got my attention. All the pressure in my life and all the stress I can't deny, it fills me up each time. Only you, you give me heaven. Oh.